dreams. She would see her daughter dwell in stately homes and palaces. Stella went to all extremes, and finally a wealthy fella showed at Stella Dallas's. Stella worked it pretty well, but in the last analysis, though Stella's daughter got the swell, all Stella got was calluses. It just goes to show that even though your family tree is bare, you still can wind up the intended of a well-to-do millionaire. It's so true, it's so real, it has such universal appeal. If a person treads the path of sin, so her daughter can eat quail. In the movies, she's a heroine, but in Brooklyn, she'd go to jail. In the movies, life is finer, life is cleaner. But in Brooklyn, it's a minor misdemeanor. In the movies, when a girl has in a week, she has a wealthy chum who can buy her presents at sex. You can start with a bagel and wind up with Conrad Nagel on the screen. But in life, you wind up right behind a pillar in the mezzanine. Feed the plot to the fish. Life is not what the movies make it seem. What's coming, Valentino? Valentino, Vilma Banky, lots of sand and hanky panky. Wait till she tries picking the sand out. Hey, wake up there, feed a barrow. You're a long way from the Sahara. In the movies, you get kidnapped by a sheik dressed in silk robes on a sand dune built for two. You lie while he gaily kisses your lobes. Then he murmurs, come, I fit you in my tent yet. But in real life, he says, did you pay the rent yet? When a girl needs male companionship on the screen, she can't keep cool. She just slouches and extends her hip while she whispers, kiss me, my fool. It's a movie tradition, but when I'm in that position, I get cramps. So I fold my tent and pay the rent and leave the vamping to the vamps. If you must be like them, your hips in and settle for